forces the devil Will has been tasked to kill.
Me! Never been better. Oh, fuck me. It's you, from the Nautiloid. Please tell me I found you before those so-called Paladins of Tyr did. Good. Great. Glad I don't have to kill you.
A great heat roars through you. Her heat, fiery as the hells. Then you're lost in visions of demonic armies as you tear through a landscape of fire and blood. The Blood War. You saw it from above as the Nautiloid passed through Avernus. This woman was on the front line.
What was that? Fuck's sake. Mountains as far as the eye can see. Guess that explains the voices. From that peak I got into your head, you've made some inroads trying to get the thing sorted. But alas, no joy. I'm Karlak, and you are... Well met, soldier. Now that we're old pals, how would you feel about helping me kill some evil bastards? A little background, if your moral compass needs something to point at. You already know I fought in the Blood War. I was good at killing demons. Really good. So good, Zariel, the archdevil herself, made me her personal attack dog. I played along until I could get the fuck out of there. Took me 10 years to properly escape, but now I'm free. Zariel sent goon after goon to hunt me down. But believe me when I tell you, I'm not going. The latest yappy little dog she sicked on me are nearby. A group of dopes posing as Paladins of Tyr. Wanna help me take them down? Fuck yes. They cornered me outside the toll house just up the hill. Doubt they've gone far after the scorching I gave them. After we've mopped them up, we can work on evicting this parasite and take Faerun by the short hairs. Sound good?
I like her. She looks like she could throw me over her shoulder and carry me to safety. Should the need arise.
I'd hug you if it wouldn't scorch your skin off. Looks like your troops all trooped up. You'll need to send someone packing if you want me to join.
If you insist. Don't have all the fun without me.
Now we're talking. I need to stop. I'm that away. Hey, we're still going after those paladins, right? Can't leave Zariel's bruisers roaming the coast. Good news. Can't wait to see him finished.
Seen that game in years.
Goblins ahead.
Shove out the claw! Drow coming through!
voice is irresistible. You recognize the overwhelming authority that you've used on others, only infinitely stronger. Your vision clouds, leaving you in a dark, featureless shadowscape. Nothingness in every direction. Then, there are three figures before you. An armored male elf, exuding power and command. A handsome younger man with a quick, easy smile. And a pale young woman with even paler eyes.
These are my chosen. They speak for me. Aid their search for the weapon, and you will be worthy to stand beside them in my presence.
The visions fade and the voice falters as a strange energy swells around you. The many-sided artifact. Somehow you understand it's repelling the presence.
My power grows. My forces gather. The reckoning draws near.
That thing's shielding us. Incredible.
Whatever power the artifact possesses, it shows no sign of it now.
Sounds like they've captured themselves a bard.
You look like you got something. Looking to spend it? Get me
in the quarry.
You or be you beheaded. Goblin kind will tease you and frown you and fall.
A stranger, did I?
Fresh disarm with me bare hands. Weaker than pixies, humans.
Oh, you got him good.
And who are you? A half elf, thinking you rule the world.
The mark glows, but you feel nothing in response. Your illithid power is beyond reach until you rest.
Well, not us. Things are changing. We got the Absolute on our side now. You better learn your place. Go on. Kiss my foot. Or I'll wipe that nasty look right off your pretty face.
Little tyrant. Teach them some manners.
Look, mate, just piss off. You're not welcome here.
The goblin stares, mouth agape. Then he sets his jaw and falls to his knees.
There. I've done it. Arrogant swine.
He kissed!
What was I saying?
Yes.
I just had to talk to
him. Raja!
I've got to take a piss.
Just licked her face!
Pinders to quick
lie. New bat from
the King. True souls are coming. The Lounders are quick.
We'll follow. A call and find great glory. All right, then.
Can't even enjoy a drink in peace.
Trash.
Then keep looking.
Lads, for the love of all that is holy, I've never clapped eyes on your poor sister.
Drop the act, hag. You was the last to see me, Rena.
Just let her go. Please.
Thank goodness you're here, sweetie. I don't know what's come over these boys.
Auntie Ethel's face creases with false concern. You realize she's lying about seeing this girl, Mayrina.
Stop this! We won't ask again!
You were supposed to rush to my defense, love. Fat lot of good you are. Some advice? You ever darken my door, you'd best have that head bowed and an apology at the ready. Bye-bye now.
Bloody hells. She just disappeared. Ain't seen nothing like that before.
She could shoot fireworks out of her backside for all I care. The hag has Rena.
It's our sister, Mayrina. She's... well... she was in a bad way after her husband died.
Started saying weird things, like how she was gonna bring him back.
Next thing, she's gone looking for the hag. Of all the stupid things to do. And we haven't seen her since. And no good ever came from dealing with a hag.
None of this matters, all right? We need to get her back, and fast! I don't remember bloody asking you.
Hold on, Joel. Let her talk. What would you suggest?
Knew it. You're full of it.
Thanks for the, advice. But we can't do that. We'll head there on our own.
Chill runs up your spine. You feel like you're being watched. The place has a quiet sense of calm. You can't see anything strange.
definitely worth a look.
Mirror. Raw magic leashed to a bauble. Almost sad.
I do not know this name. If you are known to my master, step forward and declare yourself an ally.
There is a pause.
A well-guarded laboratory. What were they hiding down here?